Hi and welcome to part 2. Let's start with the squares. I start with a blue color and I make a magic circle on the hook. Then we begin with the first double crochet and that's a chain 3. 1, 2 and 3. We make a corner. Make a chain 2 more, 1 and 2. Now we have 5 chain stitches, 1 double crochet and a chain 2. In the magic circle we make 1 double crochet. We have our first corner and V-stitch. Back in that same magic circle with 2 double crochets for a straight side. That's 1. And 2. A new corner, a V-stitch. 1 double crochet in the magic circle, then in chain 2 and 1 double crochet back in that same magic circle. This is your second corner. A straight side, 2 double crochets. That's 1 and 2. We make a third corner, 1 double crochet, a chain 2, 1 double crochet back in that circle. Then a straight side, 2 double crochets in the magic circle, that's 1 and 2. And then the last corner, number 4. 1 double crochet, a chain 2, and 1 double crochet. We have to make our last straight side, 2 double crochets in the circle, that's 1. And 2. Now pull on that short tail of the magic circle and the ring is closing like this. And now we make a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet, and that's the first chain 3. In the third chain stitch, this stitch here, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. We start on round 2 and this is also the final round and then we're done. I want to begin here in the chain 2 space. We move 1 stitch to the left with a slip stitch. Go in with your hook in that chain 2, grab your yarn, pull up and pull through for a slip stitch. Now we begin here in the chain 2 corner space and we make in this space a new corner. We begin with a first double crochet and that's a chain 3. 1, 2 and 3. This counts for a first double crochet. Back in that same chain 2 corner space with another double crochet. Then we have to make a chain 2. And now back in that same chain 2 corner space with another 2 double crochets in that same space. That's 1 and 2. And this is your new corner. On the top of the next 4 stitches, we make 1 new double crochet. Yarn over, your first stitch you see after that chain 2 corner space, on the top, on the through the V-stitch, that's 1, into the next stitch, a double crochet, that's 2, into the next stitch, 3, in the next stitch, 4. Then in the next chain 2 corner space, we make a new corner. 2 double crochets in that space. 1 and 2. Then make a chain 2. 1 and 2 and go back in that same space with another 2 double crochets to make your second corner complete. Now the straight side. Into the next 4 stitches, 1 double crochet. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this is the repeat. You work all the way around. In every chain 2 corner space, a new corner. And in every straight side, double crochets on each stitch. Then in the beginning, we make an invisible join. I'm all the way around, make all my stitches, and now I cut my yarn. And I open up that stitch, pull your hook all the way up. And now I grab a needle to make an invisible join in the beginning. For an invisible join, you skip always the first stitch. That's the first double crochet. That's the chain 3. We skip that stitch. We go to the next stitch. That's the first real double crochet here in the corner. Now on the top, on the through that V-stitch of that double crochet, go to from the front to the back, on the through that V-stitch. Now pull through. You go back to the last double crochet on the top here, only in the back loop. Then pull through, not too tight. And this here is your invisible join stitch. Now on the back, we make a little knot and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. One square done, we need to make 5 more squares, till you have 6 squares in total. If you take the hexagon, you will see that the square fits neatly on it. Make 5 more squares and I hope to see you next week, there we make the triangles. Are you here for the first time? Then please subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!